Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones. Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones. Well, here's a question that came out of my Chicago seminar last week. Interesting question. The person had a data set where someone had used word wrap to put name, address, city, state, zip, all in one cell. And, you know, I've shown how to do this before, not ever recommending this, of course. Type the name and then hold down Alt+Enter and then the address, Alt+Enter and then the city. And you basically get to control where the words wrap. And the person needed to take this text and convert it back to multiple columns or something like that. And, you know, in using text to columns, there's no good way in step two to say, hey, we want that carriage return to be the delimiter. So here's how we attack this problem. I wasn't exactly sure what to do at first. First thing I want to do is I want to turn off wrap text. That lets me see what I'm dealing with here. And you can see there is actually an unprintable character where we typed Alt+Enter. So I want to find out what that character is. And so I always attack it this way. I say I want the equal mid of this cell. Press the F4 key. And then where do I want to start? I want to start at the row of A1. That's a great way of typing 1 for a length of 1. And when I copy that down, I'm going to get all of the letters from the cell one at a time. So there's Bill, Jelen, right there. That's the character. That's the one that I want to isolate. So now this cell has just that one character. And I can use a great function called code. The code tells me that that character is a character 10. Now sometimes you're going to get data from the web and you're going to see other unprintable characters, like character 160 is real popular now on the web, and we need to convert that back to something else. So now that I know what character it is that I need to change, I'm going to use a function called substitute, equals substitute, and says, okay, where's the text? The text is here in A1. The old text. Now I need to type that character 10 there. Of course, pressing Control Enter is not going to work. So what I'm going to do is use CHAR, another function, and use the code number. So I want to convert every occurrence of character 10 to, let's say, a semicolon, and we'll close that. And so now you'll see what it does is it takes my text, and instead of having the unprintable character 10, I have a semicolon. Well, all right, convert these formulas to values. So that's, we'll do it this way. Right click, drag right, drag left, let go. Copy here as values only. You can use whatever method you'd like to use. And now that we have that with the semicolon, very easy to use text to columns. It's delimited. The delimiter is the semicolon. And click finish. And we've now separated that data out into three columns. So a little bit of a hassle, but certainly easier than going through and, you know, stripping things out again and again and again and again. I suppose you could also do this with a formula using find to figure out where that character 10 is appearing, and then using left and mid and so on to break it out. Though if you have a bunch of them, text to columns is just as easy. So I want to thank the folks in Chicago for having me out. Great question that came up during that seminar. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.